we but merely dream. We but merely dream. And yet, how badly do the dream figures that we dream of want us to fail to awaken? How badly do the dream figures that we are dreaming want us to fail to awaken? And yet, all these dream figures and their demand that we fail to awaken is but a projection, our own flavoring of the dream. Why? Because of our continuity fear. We're so used to having these dream figures insisting that we fail to awaken. This is our dream world. And for us to awaken, there won't be any more of these figures insisting that we remain asleep and dreaming. And so we wonder, what will it be like? I'm afraid to awaken. This is the continuity fear. It's the only problem we really have. These dream figures are not our problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a dream figure problem. I have a continuity problem. The continuity problem is the only problem I have. The dream figure demanding that I not awaken has no value to me whatsoever. No value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. For truly the vision of oneness is but a dream within a dream of awakening, still maintaining the dream-like state so we're not too shocked. And yet it's a dream of awakening where there are no dream figures insisting that we remain asleep. That is the dream of awakening. The world right now is full of these dream figures insisting how wonderful it is to continue our sleep, how absolutely fabulous our sleep is going to be, how great the future of this dream is going to be, how blessed we are to continue our sleep. And they continue on and on and on and on. Don't believe a word that they say. Don't believe a word that they say. They are merely expressing your continuity fear. The fact is, this dream is terrible. Our continuity fear of awakening puts words into the dream figure's mouths, a flavor, as it were. And they seem to be saying, oh, it's going to be wonderful. You don't have to wake up. You don't have to wake up. Keep dreaming, keep dreaming, keep dreaming. And we say, oh, they're telling me everyone wants me to keep dreaming. How wonderful. Maybe I'll do what they asked me to do. And lo and behold, their hands seem to have some sort of magical power to paralyze us and keep us from awakening. We feel that we're unable to awaken because the touch of all these hands, the energy from all these hands, has some sort of mystical, magical power to keep us sleeping. And yet again, this is just a projection of our continuity fear. There isn't any such power whatsoever in the dream to keep us dreaming. None. Absolutely none. It is entirely our continuity fear that keeps us sleeping. And so we say, I do not have a magic problem. I have a continuity problem. The magic problem has absolutely no value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. I do not have a magic problem. I have a continuity problem. The continuity problem is the only problem that I have. The magic problem has absolutely no value to me whatsoever. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. The greater the continuity fear, the more seductive the dream seems. The more it seems as though the dream is irretrievably calling you unto itself and that you're powerless to resist. This again 100% comes from our continuity fear of awakening. So the more we work on awakening to melt that continuity fear away, the less the dream seems to call to us. It seems to lose its grip upon us, which is exactly what we're aiming for. Bit by bit by bit by bit by bit, it tends to lose its grip upon us. When we try to awaken, we may feel some kind of spiritual vertigo. That's okay. Bit by bit, step by step, we will awaken from this dream.